Welcome to Beyond the Press channel.
Hello.
Hello.
I'm Lauri.
I'm Anni.
And I'm Pommi Henkka from Pommi Jätkät.
And today we're going to find out how easy it's going to be to explode a hole in concrete wall. And we have a couple different options. We have first hand grenades, of course. And these are not the best way, that's sure. But we're going to still try with these.
Lauri, what do you say? Of course we have hand grenade.
Yeah, of course. Yeah,
so everyone in Finland have hand grenades.
Yeah, they sell these in grocery stores.
Yes.
But if these fail for some reason, then we have two schools of thought. Lauri with the internet and Henri with the knowledge of explosives.
Yes.
And I have designed breaching charge that is made out of water jug. So this is going to forward the energy of the explosives towards the concrete.
Sounds good.
This should be like pretty similar than they use in the like army or whatever, computer games.
And today my way to get through the concrete wall is to use, of course,
C4. Yeah, of course.
And shaped charges.
Yeah.
And penetrating charges.
Yeah. So three different types of explosives, all use C4. But like just different shapes and methods of delivering the punch. And if these fail for some reason, then we have onion jackhammer as a last option. But
it may be the best option.
Yeah, but I think we are going to start the hand grenades and then we are going to test these. And we are at Lammi. This is a Perustava concrete factory. They make concrete foundations and concrete elements. And the wall that we are going to test is one of their concrete elements made here, and it's steel enforced, so much stronger than the concrete cube that we exploded earlier this year. So it's like as strong concrete wall as they get.
Yes.
Yeah, so let's see how this goes. Anne.
Yeah.
How loud is going to be?
Too loud.
Räjäytetään yksi panos! 3, 2, 1!
That is even louder than the countdown.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Basically, it didn't do anything else. And it was really loud.
Yeah.
So let's put next one against the wall.
3, 2, 1.
Okay, I have to say that surprisingly small amount of damage.
Yes, and as we knew, a C4 is really fast explosive.
Yeah.
And actually, I thought we have at least like 10 cents deep hole in here.
Yeah, but this is only like, I would say like 1 inch.
Yes.
Or a bit more.
Yes.
So not much. So we have to use a bit clever methods. Okay, so this is the idea of the shaper just you're going to use. This shape is filled with the C4 and it's going to throw this through the concrete. Maybe.
3, 2, 1.
Okay, it seemed first that it made a hole, but then when you look closer, it didn't do almost anything. On this side, the other side is also interesting, but here, the hand grenade, it did way more damage, like deeper damage than this, but let's go have a look on the other side also. So there is no hole, but this still is damaged, and I think it's because it was so hard punch that the concrete flexed slightly and this just like flew away from the momentum of the concrete itself. So pretty interesting, and I think now we are going to switch to water charges, where the water helps to like put the energy where it's needed. Okay, now we have interesting concept. This is a 2 liter water bottle, not Pepsi bottle, that would be cheating. And it's wrapped around with dead cord, and it's going to start from this end. So the idea is that the dead cord is going to try throw the water through the concrete. So it's a bit like a Finnish pressure washer. And I have no idea what it's going to do. I'm going to say that there is going to be hole, or then the wall is going to be just really clean. Two options.
3, 2, 1.
Turns out that I was wrong. It didn't went through, but it still damaged it quite much. I would say that it's similar than the hand grenade. Or a bit less, but this is really wet. And now the water chuck. It's going to work. It's going to work so well. You're going to all be surprised. Okay, it's time to make the hole. So my water chuck. There is wild guesses about amount of the explosives. I would say maybe 300 to 400 grams. And the idea is that it's going to be between the water jack and the concrete wall, the explosives. So it's bit like on the middle of the concrete. And if you saw what 2 kilos of dynamite does for 1 cubic meter of concrete, then this is pretty much. If you think it in that way. So I'm pretty sure that this is going to make it.
Actually, we have here almost 600 grams.
Yeah, and this is going to double the effect when I add the duct tape.
Yeah, should we give some kind of name of this?
Yeah. It's the
Laurin kusisäiliö.
No. It's wet. Wet. It's wet fart.
Yes.
Yeah, that's the name.
Yeah.
Okay. There it is, and it's really close to the wall, so it's not going to leak the pressure from there, and I really think that it's going to go through. What is your opinion? It's going to go through?
No.
No?
No.
No?
No.
No chances?
No. Not at all.
Okay. I think I'm only one that believes that it's going to go through.
Palo! 3, 2, 1!
It was success.
Yesterday I was really sure that it's going to work.
Yes.
Today it was a bit hard to be confident when I was like only one who thinks that it's going to work. But I have to say that it worked even better than I thought.
I think so too. Actually I was worried about that. That was not enough water behind the charge.
Yeah. There was actually more water on that than the like pros use. I was a bit worried about the like, because it was quite thin like layer of explosives. It was like large pad, but not very thick.
Okay.
I was a bit worried about that, but it was probably more than enough still.
Okay, of course, yes, we have a great hole in here, but still we have problem with the steels.
Yeah. Hey, let's go have a look on the other side. And there isn't much damage elsewhere, and even the plastic container is not completely gone, so you wouldn't probably be able to stand like next to this, but like behind the corner, pretty close, probably could survive. Really loud it would be. But I'm so pleased that I was right.
Yeah, really beautiful hole.
Yeah. Hey, let's have a look on the high speeds. Thank you. Okay, then it's time for the last explosion. Now we are going to use regular saber charges, like linear ones, long ones. And now they are little bit away from the wall, so there is more distance for the like metal stream to form in right shape and get the best possible result. I think it's not going to go through. But let's see. Hey Henkka, almost through.
Almost through.
But not quite, but really close. And I have to say that the concrete is surprisingly strong.
It is.
Yeah, and even with the hole, there's still the steels. So it doesn't work like on the video games that you put on concrete wall like explosives, small explosion and you can walk through. Because if you would like to cut the steels also on the same go, that's quite a blast.
That's true. So concrete is really hard, and that's true.
Yeah, and thanks for Perustava for borrowing their concrete wall.
That's the result.
That's the result. Yeah, and if you like to see more explosions and see how these are made, Henry's video has also footage from concrete factory.
Yes, we speak Finnish, but still we have English subtitles, so yeah. Let's go and check it out.
So you can learn from concrete and how to speak Finnish.
And when you learn Finnish, you can get the girls.
Yeah. But that is all for today.
Thanks for watching.
And have a nice day.
See ya.